Vortex.
All right, that was a noob mistake. Hey, Bucked Up. Hey, Toxic. Thank you, Dreadmalex. This one's got 18,753, and it's counting down. So maybe I'll try this one here out. I got a little bit of time, and let's see how it goes. I think for starters, I may go ahead and with my Assault Torp Bees. I want to try them out. Give me a gunboat in there. Alright, I guess I ought to try getting some music. I'm drinking a couple of beers already, so drinking some Coronas, and I don't know, this is only my second one, but I kind of feel like I might not want any more after this. Let's see. Yeah, 75s are new dredges. Yep. Yeah, there used to be 75 dredges. Yep. They took them away when they changed the dredges. They took the old 75s away because they were easier than the 60s. I don't know if the Assault Torp Bees will work in here or not, so that's mainly what I'm wanting to try out. I wanted to see if the Assault Torp Bees will work. I've never actually tried one yet, but I want to see how hard they are to prep. I think once you prep them, I know they've got the shroud in there. They got a shroud building in there, and so you have to go in the top left first. Hey, Fear, thank you, Preston. Hey, Joel, fast shot. Yeah, they had 75s before, but they got rid of them is because when they updated the 60s, the 60s were harder than the 75s, and the 75s paid out better. So they got rid of the 75s. So now we got new 75s. They've been out for a while, so, I mean, we've not had 75s for a while. I'm the man. Can you turn that fan up? Do I got the... I don't have the remote. You got the remote? Cool. I'm the man. Yeah, I gotta try to knock out. I've seen the inside of 75 through YouTube. I've already seen a couple of YouTube videos of them, and I've seen the pictures. But this is actually going to be my first attempt at trying one. Wish me luck, guys. Think it's gonna let me in there today? I did tell it to attack, right? Or did I? There we go. Boy, that was a long time. Oh. Looked like somebody came in from the bottom before. Man, that little marker jumps all over the place, doesn't it? Well, look at there. It is possible. It can be done. Alright, let me just go ahead and get these guys down here and try to get them stacked a little bit better. Alright, turrets, I see, I think that's a javelin there. Can't really tell. Maybe it's a pyroclastic. There's a javelin, though. And the javelin, as I recall, from right here to right here should be safe. I'll check, test that theory in a second. Let's see. Gunboat should be good right here. Yeah, see, so the javelin doesn't have any additional range or anything. It should get shot, like, right about now. No, the javelin's actually got really short range. Alright, let me just jump out and jump back in real quick. The gunboat's dead now, so I'm going to retreat and go back in. Hey, thanks for click and follow there. Might as well wreck it. You got a really long name, man. My kitty cat had a lot of lines on it. Alright. Alright, now we're going to go do some damage. The point now is to go in and do some damage. Come on, there we go. Now, I do have my assault torps completely red trade. They're R15. And R15 gives you accuracy and damage, or accuracy and fire rate, actually. So the fire rate from the assault torps plus, I'm sorry, the fire rate buff from there plus the fire rate from my rank should, you know, really gets me some pretty good, a pretty good fire rate. These things are really slow, though. I'm actually in the process right now of... Well, actually, I'm actually retrofitting the Nighthawk call right now. I'm going to, like, R3, I think. But, I was working on my compound engines. The compound engines are stuff like the Magnus Drive. Anything that mixes speed and turn, like speed system, is all done by the compound engines. I've got my regular engine system up to like R12, but I think I've only got my compound up to like R2 or 3. See if I can kill it off this time. They didn't all start firing at the same time. That's why it looks like a stream right now, but take what I can get, you know what I'm saying? Probably should have stayed. Yeah, might just regret that little move right there. Yeah, I'm gonna regret it. Come on, let's go under. Come on, guy. Oh, that a-hole is shooting at me. All right, let's see if that'll work. Damn, it'll kill it. Jerk. Just saying. One of those guys did that much damage to a Spectre. Un-freaking-believable. See that? He's like trying to climb back in the womb up there. This is like forever way of doing it though, I think. Oh, here he comes. He starts shooting at me again. Crap. Alright. I was kind of hoping I'd be able to get a little piece of him. That's all good. I do got my retreat button is fully loaded right now, so I can use it if I need it. Well, there you go, man. All of the boats in here can be prepped. Assault torpedoes, that's where it's at. Oh, not that again. My voice isn't matching with the video. It seems like the only way for me to fix that is to reboot my computer. I don't know what it is on my computer that's causing it. Hey, Kinger. Comics. Sure would like to get another little piece of that drone right there. He's too fast though. He does seem like he always goes back and, I guess he's like hiding behind that turret at the moment. I know he's there though. I might go in there and get some here in a second. Took me up. I asked a guy at work for some today if he had any mints. He like keeps a stash, like he's like the prison salesman who sells cigarettes or whatever. And he actually has a couple of snack drawers in his desk that he sells snacks out of it for like 50 cents, which is like half the vending machine. I asked him if he had any mints, and he handed me a bag. It turned out it was gum, and he just told me to grab a few mints out of it. I thought it was mints, but it turned out, like I said, it was gum. Probably should have went up there and snagged another one of them gunboats. But, you know, I don't particularly care for the gum. And it tasted like diet stuff, too. It didn't taste good. It tasted like low calorie. Yeah, it was like Trident. It was some kind of Trident gum. It was a bag. That was a bag, though. It wasn't like the small packs or anything. It was a bag. More placement ads. Oh, yeah, get those sponsors. Man, it would be so cool, man, if somebody that I just like, if I just like held up my Corona right there, if they start sending me a check, man, how awesome would that be? I would love that. I'd take down my tip jar if I could make money like that. What did you guys think of the Thursday show, man? Everybody in here watched the show last night? That's true, Battlestar. Yeah, it's not sponsored by anybody. No sponsors. Man, if I had my assault torps on Nighthawks, I'd be done already. Oh crap, I just screwed up. Yeah, I jumped out of here. So what's my time looking like? 19 minutes. This is my original Sector 16 that I'm currently in. And, you know, they know me here. So anyway, do I get love when I show up? No, I don't get love when I show up here. What ended up, they asked me, are you here to hit the sector? That was the first thing I was asked. The second one was, can they expect any more NBK? I thought that was freaking hilarious. And I let them know I hadn't hit a base in months, and they're like, well, good. I'm like, I said, but I'm still anti-bully. And then one of them tried to say I was a liar, that I was a bully because NBK hit a memorial here. So just drama, drama, drama everywhere. Right, right. They thought I was the leader or something. I don't know what they were thinking. Just because they said I got like a huge web presence. I'm like, whatever. Somebody told me that Reapers would do really good in here, too. I should probably try my Reapers in here. Freaking software that I use, crap, try to update on me. If I can keep from losing one, I want to try. Rather than trying to chase them and lose them, I'm just going to go out and come back in again. The next roundtable is tomorrow. What did you guys think of the show last night? I'm looking for feedback. I want to see what you guys thought of the show last night. You know, anybody here get to watch the Thursday show? I kind of, you know, because Nash and Liam weren't on, I thought I would go ahead and do something that I wouldn't never be allowed to do with either of them on, so. Did things a little different. Oh, I need Battlestar on today. Oh, you're friends with them? He's very young. Vengeance Gamer 1337 is very, very young. He said he's been playing for like 4 years and he's only 12. Battles from one target. Yeah, I got a terrible memory. Hey, Malias. Time to go get me a ship to bring up here. I'm gonna get the Hellstrikes. What do y'all think of that? Where the heck are the freaking Hellstrikes at? Oh, wait a second. They're probably not even in the spot. So we got a flagship right there. Actually, what is 2 and 5 in it? Launch. a long ways from a tower. Yeah, well, I got a trick that I do to keep my health strikes from being a long repair. You know, I don't kill them, for one. But the Highlander nuke cruiser helps reduce damage that it takes. And also, I split them up. I don't stack them. So they're not all taking the same damage. Oh. Oh, is that you right there? Might as well wreck it. I guess it is. That's funny stuff. Well, you're a new guy. I see you got a 17.4 million ID. You're pretty new. I just bucked up. Oh, dang, there's still another freaking boat up here. Dang it, I thought I had the sucker clear. Oop, here I am hitting the wrong buttons. Man alive. More boats. What was it, like five of them big freaking boats in here? Alright, I gotta fix this music because that's Kelric and I can't stand Kelric. Gotta go. Yeah, I see depth charges. I can see depth charges on that hull. I can't promise anything. It's like one of those first come, first thing serve type deals. Wreck it. It's like a first come, first serve type deal. So basically, I put the link out 10 minutes before the show. If you click join, then you'll get a pop up, a notification. So we try to encourage that. People actually, you know, like RSVPing type thing. But there's only 10 spots, and obviously I'm going to be in one of them. Extreme XC29 might be another one. Liam could be there. It's just kind of really hard to say. Come on, sucker. Oh crap, I screwed up. Stop it. That crap's not cool. I'm gonna quit shooting guns at me. Alright. Now I need the retreat button. Let me zoom out so I know there's no more freaking boats. Man, I am hot. It is warm. Warm. I have to turn the air conditioning up. Something. That's the beer. My wife said it's the beer. Alright, let's do this again. Retreat. Minutes left. Come on, let's get some uranium. Yeah, this is a 75. See, the first trick is you don't stack your boats in here. You don't want to stack, because basically when you stack your boats, that's like that fire right there. Instead of it hitting one, it would have hit both of them, because that's actually splash damage. All right? So you don't stack. Stacking bad. Man, these turrets are really tough. I don't see any rockets, but I see the pyroclastics. Now at this point, I just split them up and see how it works out. This is my first time trying this, so hopefully I'm not being incredibly stupid. Time will tell. Alright, two is shooting at a building. That is bad. Nah, screw it. Might as well just go with it. Look. Freaking shoot at the turrets, not at the buildings. My god. See, my number one's coming down. That's not good. All right, so all the turrets are gone. Alright, I'll take that. $38,694 uranium right there. Now Now, the new dredges will be spawning in like 8 minutes, and I have a little bit of time on my crew. I got like 15 minutes on my crew, so I may go ahead and try putting my my Frosty and my Kodiak's Mastodon fleet, because I know I can take two dredges, 260s with that, and see if I can go out and do that when the new ones respawn. Yeah, they're not supposed to be easy. Be right back. I'm just going to grab my, I got a Diet Coke in the fridge. I'm going to grab it. Yo, I'm back. Alright, let's see here. Just drinking Diet Coke, but I gotta tell you, it's not very good. It tastes like it's got a little bit of age on it. So that doesn't taste fresh. A Dreadmall X. Boom! I'm just saying. That's how you jump. How's that for awesome? It's my boom screen. That's 2.5 hours, that's an hour and a half, so we got 4 hours worth of repairs there. But on this one right here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this fleet over. Oh crap, I had another one I could have extended. Dang it. Dang it. Rage. Rage, rage. Now your position, when you're positioning your boats, you got to be very methodical and you know, crap, okay? So basically, obviously your flagship is in the very front, okay? The two boats directly attached to it are positions 3 and 4, okay? And the ones all the way in the back are positions 4 and 5. Now that doesn't work that way when you have empty slots in your fleet, though, okay? So just keep that in mind. If you have empty slots in your fleet, it gets all screwed up. Get off of there, man. What the heck? All right, there we go. See, that's 2 hours, 51 minutes there. That bites. But I need lots of uranium. I'm actually I was pretty low. I mean, I got 45,000 now, but I just got 38, right? 39, something like that. So I had like 6,000. Currently, I am currently retrofitting Nighthawk R3. There we go. Because, you know, I was almost out of uranium. I wasn't sure if I was going to get any or not. So basically, I just figured I've got a time. I got a few days where I can go ahead and it's 4 days, 15 hours. Where I can go ahead and just stock up, see how much uranium I can get. Try to rebuild, you know what I mean? I don't know how much R4 is. I don't remember. I'd have to go back and look at my old slides, but... you know what I'm saying. Alright, so these guys are getting ready to respawn, so I'm going to go ahead and just launch. Head to a tower. I like to have my Nighthawks around just in case. Just in case, you know. If it looks like somebody's going to try to ninja me, I'll take care of them. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I don't know. It's okay. Wreck it. Might as well wreck it. It's okay. Y'all really like the boom screen, man. The boom screen is awesome. It's awesome. The boom screen's great. I need to make one of those for my other games. Boom. Even if you hit my base, I really don't care. If you hit my base, I'd be cool with it. I don't care. I really hope they would leave my dock so I can continue playing, but if they don't, then I'll just switch games. I mean, I'm not going to lie to you. I got another game that I'd rather be playing anyway. I'm just kind of doing this out of necessity, you know what I mean? I just figure if I'm going to be sticking around Battle Pirates, I might as well not be, like, drifting behind constantly, you know what I mean? I mean, I guess we all sort of kind of are, but I just don't need to come to a dead halt. 1 minute. How do you personally send people messages, and where at? You're talking about in the game? Might as well wreck it? Talking about inside Battle Pirates? If you do, you can either do it on the base, click message, or you can go to the name inside the comms. Like if I wanted to send Banzai down there a message, I can click there and say message. And Twitch, similar. You can, like right now, I got my mouse on top of Battlestar 92. I can click on him there, and then there's an envelope right there. Alright, I see a 40. Why do I got you bookmarked? Come on, judges, where you at? Time's ticking, man. Time is ticking. I got 7 minutes left on this thing. I need to get moving. As long as I'm in the second one, if I'm in the second one, I'm cool. I'll get the double U. As long as I don't die. What the heck, man? No, they're spawning right now. The new dredgers are supposed to be spawning, but for some reason... Alright, I'm going to go ahead and just jump in this guy right here. Even though he's not, like, max or anything, let me see here. The stupid bookmark thing is not even... I mean, it's still 18,000, I guess. and you're running out of time, you don't really have the luxury of shopping around, you know what I'm saying? All right, so usually what I'll do here is I'll try to tell my where click on the map where I want my mastodons to go, and then I'll go ahead and I'll jump into my Kodiaks. Like my number 4, I'll bring it down here, and I put my number 3 right here. And then I don't use my Frosty right off the get-go, all right? But I do all of this so that I can start maneuvering them. See that? See, they're all picking on the Kodiaks, and meanwhile they're getting shot. That's what I like. I like them getting shot. Man, he had a freaking depth charge on him. Holy crap. Alright. Now my Frosty is a lot faster than all my other boats, so that's kind of a problem. This guy right here, because he's facing to the right, I won't go this way, okay? Because I don't like him kiting me. I'd rather kite him, if you know what I'm saying. Kiting him is what I'd rather do. Okay, I got to try to stay in the circle a little bit. I just had to watch out for the fire. Fire. You see how the mortars are coming in? I got to make sure they're not, like, close to my other boats. At least he's shooting at the other boat, not this one. And my mastodons, I mean. This might actually be my only one, I'm sad to say. Now I gotta use my Frosty. But it's okay. I can make it work. Now here I just gotta maneuver my Frosty away from my Mastodon, so everything is shooting at the Frosty and not the Mastodon. I can start cleaning off the island. I need to get my yellow circle to cover up part of the island here. Oh crap, screwing that up too. My Mastodon's on fire. Mastodon's on fire is bad. Alright, we got this, man. It's pretty much cleaned up at this point. Alright, now this guy here, because he's facing the right, is the direction I want to approach him from. Hey, Comics. Can you see my Mastodon build? Yeah, I'll show it to you, but I'm not gonna lie. I'm not proud of this fleet. Hey, Vengeance. Well, that is cool, I suppose. I just need to get closer up there with the yellow circle. That's the remote targeting range. There we go. Probably could have used a pinch on that, but it's okay. What I'm doing is I'm running behind the land. Take the torpedoes away from them, but I didn't quite get away, but it's all good. I'm not going to be able to take a second one with this fleet, I'll tell you that right now. So this guy's pretty much done. It's expired anyway. Alright, that might be it for the dredges for right now, guys. And there's a 75. I want to try something. This might be a little reckless, but, you know, sometimes I just feel a little reckless. However long, I don't know, man. I don't really put time limits on myself there, buddy. I can stop streaming at any time, or I can continue streaming for another 5 hours, man. I've done some 6-7 hour, 8 hour streams, and even longer on other games. I just want to see something real quick. I want to see how good I can do in here with my my Nighthawk. So, feeling a little reckless, a little frisky. So, kill him real quick. I just wanted him mainly out of the way, because I do plan on going in there and going for this other big boat here. But I want to run. I'm just really curious, you know, how that would work. Seeing if I can do this with my siege torps. So far, so good. No damage. What's going on, these nuts? Come here, you. I think he's a little scared. What y'all think? He looks scared of y'all? He looks scared of me. Fire. Come here, you. No? Well, looky here, man. How's that for awesome? I can just, like, activate all of them if I want to. Oh, I did take a little bit of damage from the fire. I see a smidge of red on my ships. But still. Hey, RG Smith. I did get me one. I got me like 57,000 uranium so far, and one of those was from a 75. I did a 75 and a 63, something like that. So I'm pretty happy. But I need these I need these boats because I need to start my Forsaken missions. I haven't started them yet, and only thing I'm gonna get on the fourth tier is. Firebat drones. I haven't gotten those yet, so I'm gonna get those, and then I guess I'll get my tokens. 12-hour research token, 1-hour research token, and it's all gonna come. That'll be cool. And then, and of course, the uranium, 25,000 uranium. Oh, Bill, I'm sorry. Here we go. Mastodons. This is what I got on them. I got six siege torp Z's. I'm sorry, siege missile Z's. I just put laser one on there. It's for accuracy and retargeting. Excuse me, is why I put that on there. Solid fuel booster 3, obviously, for max range. Speed system 3. And then the alloy armor MC3. I have not put any armor on these. And the reason why I never put any armor on these is because I don't know when I paired these up with my Kodiaks. I mean, if you look at my weight right here, and I actually built this to go with my Savage Kodiak, believe it or not. And, let's see if I can find my Savage Kodiak real quick. There it is. But you see how my weight is. I actually didn't have any room for armor. That's why I never put any armor on my Mastodons. But I went ahead and I built two more Kodiaks. I'm like, screw it. I'm just going to make a Kodiak fleet, and then I'll just have my Mastodons go with the Frosty, you know, or whatever I decide to put it with, you know what I mean? And that way I can put some armor on the Mastodons. But the Mastodon, this fleet really sucked in bases, okay, is because the Executioner missiles... The Executioner missiles have this special on them. They're supposed to have this special on it. Smart warheads. That basically it targets the lowest health ship. So basically, they would always go for my Mastodons whenever my Mastodons were in range, because my Mastodons didn't have any armor. So they would always pick on my Mastodons. So that's what happened. So I just didn't think that one out. But that's what lack of practical experience gets you. Let's see here. So hopefully that helped you out there, Comics. Yeah, and I didn't want to tweak my. I'm not gonna lie. I didn't want to mess my. I didn't want to mess my Kodiaks up. To. There we go. That thing's too big and it gets in the way. But my Kodiaks are actually not too bad. I really do like these Kodiaks. I probably should have went with a little bit more strike missiles on there. I put the Cutlass on there for splatter. It's a little bit extra range to get my Mastodon shooting a little quicker. But now that I'm not going, well, I guess I technically I am still using it with my Mastodons. But these guys here got pretty good armor on them. I got two D5Es, a CP4, and a couple of D4Rs. And I really like this. You know, I think if I just tweaked it and got my other ones. I actually did build two more Kodiaks. I just never finished them. And that's the story of my life. It's not following my own advice, really. You see, there's really, it's just a blank hole. There's nothing else on it. And I got two of those. Story of my life. And right now, I've got... I got the armor going on my Crusaders, so that's why I'm not using my Crusaders currently. Alright. Well, anyway, let me go ahead and start working on my Forsaken mission. You know what? Hey, guys, if you can stand by for a couple of minutes, what I'll do is I'm going to just reboot my computer to fix this whole audio thing, because I know it's a pain in the butt, okay? So if you can give me a few minutes, I'll be right back, all right? And I'm just going to reboot my computer, all right? So, you know, 5 minutes for me to reboot and get set back up. If that's cool with you guys. Boom! I'll see y'all in a few minutes.
The price is wrong, bitch.